Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to Microsoft's Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz. I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft, and I'm once again joined by Kirk Pepperdine, who's going to talk to us about part three on the topic of classes and packages. Kirk, do you want to tell us a little bit more about what we're talking about?
Thank you, Brian. In this final segment, we'll look at how fully qualified class names form a namespace in the runtime, and that how that helps us avoid namespace collisions.
The final bit of the story is a little bit more about the namespace that the fully qualified class names make. In this case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down into the source directory, and we're just going to copy the person class up into a new package. So I'm going to go into the com, and I'm going to make a util directory. Oops, just having typing fun. So, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy from the model directory this person.java class. So I'm going to drop that into the util directory. Now, at this point, you might say, okay, we just have two identical classes, but simply in separate packages. So what would happen now is if I compile both of these classes, then the class that I compiled last would overwrite the class that got compiled first. And what would happen in that case is that, you know, that's like kind of an unpredictable result because you generally don't know which class is going to be compiled before the other. And that's because the fully qualified names are still the same. And as we saw in the initial demo, if we just compile a source file, it's just going to use the fully qualified name to create the directory structure that we need. And it's going to put the class file down there. And it doesn't really care if there's a class file there or not. It's just going to overwrite it. What we want to do in this particular case is we want to go in. And what we'd like to do is just to make sure that we change the fully qualified name to match the directory structure that we're in. Okay, so now we can back up, I think, into the one more. To get to here, so I'm going to go into the classes directory. I'm going to do rf minus rf star. There's nothing there anymore. Okay, I can get rid of our person.jar. Okay, so we're just left with our free with all of our artifacts. So we can take a look at that and see. Okay, so now I can do a Java C minus D. Classes, because that's where we want the compiler output to go. And in this case, what I need to do is I need to specify all of the classes here. So here I can do a star.java. So that will pick up all of the classes in that package. And then I can specify again source com util star.java. And that will pick up all of the Java files in that directory. And we can run either class, and you can see that we're going to get the results that we absolutely expect in this case. If you want a real-world example of this, I would suggest that you look at the JDK classes javautil.date and javasql.date. If you look at these classes, you'll find that they have a different representation of date that is best suited for their own particular purpose. I hope that you found this presentation useful, and I would encourage you to watch the other presentations in this series.
Thanks, Kirk. That was really great. That concludes the topic of classes and packages for this series. Please check out the rest of the topics in Microsoft's Java for Beginners series.